beside you, it might be the last time you see that person. If you love that person, say, I love you now. I tell you, I am happy because I tell my brother all the time, I love you. I find time to walk with him God wrong, and he laugh after me because me live a town, him say me no about farming. But me try use the machine and me try use the picker same way. Let us be happy. Have a blessed day.
Shall we praise the Lord? Shall we worship the Lord?
I hear the sound of a mighty rushing wind, and it's closer now than it's ever been. I can almost hear the trumpet. We'll be right back.
And what I'm feeling from the past month or so, it's unbearable. But the Lord give and take. And listen, whatever he done, no question me. But it always said to me, say, Ian, if you figure out prison or death, what happened to me? But it is here now and you don't know what happened to me. But I'm hurt. But it's the Lord that have done this. And what I have to say today, it will be short. I never do a water baptism yet. And the passing of Patrick let me think different. Said to me millions of times, listen, he has never baptized, I don't, and we have a drink. You know how really I'm scared. I will never tell we a drink. He said, anything with me here, I'm going to call you. He couldn't call me that Tuesday morning then. Because he never knew, say, Mr. Deadman, I'll come for you. Bear with me, please, people. Let me express myself. I have been to this town and everything but this one. Me make it. Because me got doctor last week Friday, me lose 15 pounds. And I said, the road is up to trouble. So that was Patrick time gone. Anytime Patsy put a beer in mouth, he call Ian. He said, oh, for you, the boy, come check me. He said, me don't know Ryo. He said, Ryo, move from party in it. He said, me a commune. Then he said, Ian, galang. Can you know, say, not tap call till you come. But there is race for
Hallelujah! Apart from it. perfect example. We have given them the time that they ease the mind. No? I don't know, Patrick was looking at the picture and said, yes, I've seen him before, always smiling. Amen?
Amen.
And I hope that Ian will stand to his words, followed by the rest of brothers. You all can make a men choir in a church. Amen? And Ian, may you stand to what you said and give God your life. And I'm sure the other brothers will follow you who have not yet accepted Jesus. He asked that we pray for him. Amen?
Amen.
They did a great rendition that I know reached to the hearts of so many. It brings tears to my eyes. Remember, he said, pray for us. And Ian, I'm a listener to hear that you'll give your life to Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Bless the Lord. Our second lesson comes to us from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, reading from verse 51 to 58. It will be read by Sashai K and Sashai Gay Williams. These are their twins. Yes, let's have them. Amen.
Good afternoon, everyone. The scripture reading is taken from 1 Corinthians 15, verse 51 to 58. Here begin it. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed. In the moment, in the twinkling of the eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall rise. Dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must be put in corruption, and the mortal must be put on immortal. When this corruptible shall have put in corruption, and the mortal shall put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory.
Amen.
O death, why is thy sting? O grave, why is thy victory? The strength of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord God Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For our hearts, as we know that your labor is not in vain, is in the Lord.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We are calling the brothers to come and do the take up the offering for us. Amen. Bless the Lord. The hymn is, there's a land beyond the river that we call the sweet forever. And along the reach a shore by a fence we reach. One by one we get the portals, there to dwell with the immortals when they ring the gold.
Oh, no, dear.
Hallelujah. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the rock. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us give thanks for the offering. Eternal God and most holy Father, we honor you, Lord, and we adore you. You are so good to us. And Father, as your children, O God, freely give their offering, Lord, to your work. We pray, God, that thy blessing will be upon them. Lord, we pray, God, as they give to you, that you will bless everything that they put their hand to make a living. Lord, bless their business places, O God. Bless every one of them, their home and their family. Lord, touch them and help them, O God, that they will draw nearer to you. Hear us this afternoon and bless your people as we deliver them in your hands and give you thanks. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Let the church praise the Lord. Let the church praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let the church praise the Lord. Oh, one more time.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Good to be in the presence of God.
Amen.
Amen. Because all of the ground is sinking sand. But I'm Christ. And Christ is solid rock. I stand. I'm going to do this other segment. I'm glad to be here, amen, for this part. Pay that.
Patrick is my friend.
Patrick is my friend from many, many years. Such a good man to me. And I miss him very much. He and his wife, they are so good to us. And I can see for the goodness that they have done. Amen, the turnout that they received from their brethren come to pay their last respect. My heart is going out for them all, and extending my condolence to the Williams and also the Rankin family. My condolence going for you all. May God continue. May God continue to comfort your heart. You is in his ways. Go on with it. I'm going to go on with the program. And this time the remembrance is coming from Dwight. Dwight Williams may come now with his remembrance. That's the one of your brother. Please come, Dwight. Okay, we have some tribute here, amen, about four more, and it's one is from Shalise Sims, Shalise Sims Landon, sister, could come now with his tribute. Yes, that's all right, her tribute. She here? Okay. And if you look on your sheet there, you could see it come down in order. So we could follow the protocol on the sheet, and you come to pay your tribute as it is on the program. Huh? If it's not here, then Dundee.
Dundee.
Williams.
Hello everybody, good afternoon. Good afternoon everybody. I'm here to do a little reading here that I work on myself. So I want to do it. Yes, I'm a bit nervous, but you gotta see. I know what's going on. Alright? Okay, the readings are about, never you question the Lord why. You must always accept anything in life. That is a must. Never you question the Lord after he put in his handiwork. He said love and not hate. Always give the Lord thanks, even when you're going through rough times. And please remember to pray to the Lord. Ask for help and strength every single moment of your life. And while praying, always pray for your greatest enemies. It's a hard road to travel and a mighty long way to go. But always remember, there's a loving God above all of us. Where you go in life, wherever you rich or you're poor, that is given to all of us, even though some go before some. So today we are here to celebrate the death of my loving uncle. We all know the type of person you are, uncle. We all love you. We're gonna remember every single moment we spent with all of us. The Lord knows why he put you like this. Nobody that today we're gonna spend a moment like this with you, my uncle. Uncle, when you were here with us, especially when me and you and Daddy having a good time and Mr. Johnson together, you always say, me a go wrong, later, tomorrow, you soon go link on. Now you're going for a market, I'm here for the road. Nobody, tomorrow, later. Father God, I'm here today, and you already know that we're here to celebrate the death of my Uncle Patrick. And I'm gonna say some few words, not what I write on the phone right here. All right. Meanwhile, my uncle got it up on the work. The phone a ring. Say, can't come down, you know. We dey on the chapel later. Look at who, baby, quick. Quick. Look at who. Look on the phone. Daddy, come to Uncle Patrick. Baby, answer him, man. Hear what I say. So Uncle, what go on? You know the road, Joe? Away there. You know, come check me. Eh? You know, come. I'll run a night, man. Come check me, man. Yeah, I know the baby. Let me say that. Alright. We always there. Me and Daddy always go to look for my Uncle Patrick. Always. If it's even to drink a water. My uncle always like to give me something. Even when I'm at home, I call Uncle. I say, Uncle, I'm not a vegetable, you know. Uncle, we want ease up my cereal. We want something to blend. We want some like carrot. Where are? Come check me. Come check me. Even if I'm going to get mega glen. Me a come. As I reach. That is my start. Uncle, you know me not on gas. Don't you roll you? The only money I don't gas. He said, Uncle, just give me 5 bills, man, I'm going to gas. It's 5 bills. Give me 5 bills, huh? I'll turn down again. Now you're going for a market, make it no money. I'll make it no money. He said, Uncle, give me 3 bills, I'm going to gas. See the way I act, right? Can't be done in them. Tell him I gotta go. All right. When I look, Uncle, good on my pocket now, come on. Is that $1,000, $500, never $300? Buy some gas, I'm going to buy it. I'm going to tell you. Always something like that. I always call my uncle and always, he always has something to give. As always, he has something to give to me. What a grown provision. I'm at my home, I don't have any money, I call uncle. I said, Uncle, give me some money. Always, as always. Always asking for Mr. Johnson. Always asking for Daddy. I ride my bicycle to check uncle. I just go by and check my uncle. So I'm just here today to celebrate the death of my uncle. And may his soul rest in peace. May his soul rest in peace. I'm here today, but I don't know what I'm here for.
I don't know. I'm just here. I'm just pretending like I'm at church. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know what I'm here for. So I'm doing something. So I just want everybody to hold faith and keep up. Right? We keep up and go on and let the Lord know best. And we all know what to do. So we give thanks and praise and carry on. Life and death.
You don't have to worry, and don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning, troubles they don't last away. Remember there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away.
Good afternoon, everyone. Let me hear the people praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let me hear you praise him another time.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. I pray we all be ready. I pray we all be ready. I pray we all be ready for his return. I pray we'll get our business straight so we can all meet.
close to the Word. Amen. And so, because we are so close to the Word, then we kind of have the floral shoot. But the flowers, but we are going to do the choir now. And during the choir, then you can go ahead. You have a song for yourself? Okay. Come along then, when we're going to do that part. Amen. Now it's time for the floral shoot. Please come. Thank you.
Crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Make his path straight. For he came as a quickening spirit. And it grieves my heart when I see one and know God himself every time that one passed without him, because you are his masterpiece. So I want you to ask the person beside you, how valuable is your soul? Ask the person beside you, how valuable is your soul? Don't look up me, ask the person, look beside of you. Ask that person, how valuable is your soul? I want to share a little bit very quickly with you. From the book of Mark, Mark chapter 8. And this is what Jesus said. From verse 36. He said, "For what will it profit a man if he gain the world and lose his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul?" This is not a joke business. Cuss pastor if you want to. Cuss the church if you want to. But it is appointed unto man once to die. But after that comes the judgment. I'm here to preach to the dead because he's already dead. There is nothing I can do for him because he's dead. And if he lost his way, it is his fault and not mine. It is not your fault. It is his fault. There is nothing that God can do for him when he's dead. Every man has a choice. You have a choice. I have a choice. I love Sister Nadine, you know. Love her.
Yes.
And every time I try to shout him when I pass, shout her. Every time she comes to church, she's always coming and trying to help. And I listen to those who give truth. I listen to that group, brothers and everybody that was here. And I watch the young man shine in the casket. But does it help? your home, lock up yourself in your house, burn up by yourself, fear to walk on the street, fear to get up, fear to lie down, fear to move. Because your soul, listen to what Paul said, he said, I pray that you prosper as your soul prosper. If your soul not prosper, you're not prospering. What do you call prosperity, God said? So what profit is there? You sell yourself, but yet your soul is in touch. And lose your own soul. He says, one soul now. One soul. Your husband no response for it. Your wife no response for it. See how my wife still sit on yourself. Listen to me. Everything we work for, maybe somebody else will get it. The very wife somebody else might get her. Looking at me strange. Solomon says a wickedness I've seen under the sun. What wicked, he called it wickedness. He said it's an evil that I've seen under the sun. A man worked all his life. He tired his life gaining the world. Everything that he tried to gain. And yet when he died, the next man come go get him. Our next woman come from the field. I think I'm just talking about she's still young and look good and fresh. So she passed today and she passed for 1 week and she passed for 2 weeks. And after the year finished, she was my next man. She needs somebody to help her along. It's reality. Look at the pastor. And things the pastor have got foolishness. The pastor speak wisdom. If it was she died, he cried, yes, I have a good wife. But after a year passed, or maybe 2 years passed, he's gonna find another wife.
Yes.
So what profit is there? Solomon said it's an evil that I've seen under the sun. A man labor, he tired all his life, forget about his one soul, and yet he lost his soul. Why? Trying to gain wealth and riches.
We hear 1 year too much, Bishop, sometimes
oh,
one.
God Almighty. And we work, and we try to gain the wealth, and then after gaining the wealth, we have to spend the wealth and our health, and wealth cannot buy health.
It's an evil. Solomon said that I've seen under the sun. He said, I have done all of this. I have been there and I've done that. So he said, young man, let your heart cheer you. Walk in the path of your heart. But know this, for all these, God shall bring every work into judgment, whether it is good or evil. So Jesus said, what profit have a man to gain everything? And what? The one soul. And then you blame the pastor, you say, pastor. And you blame sister so-and-so and say, sister so-and-so. And my wife and my husband. And this one and that one. No, it's your fault. Do you know that God will save everybody? But he said you have a choice. That's why, my brother, you don't go on with nobody. I give you the word, because you don't want to. Because I'm giving you right. A lot of people don't want rights. Tell them you're wrong. even in one part, even when I'm not cutting you. All of us who stop being in them, not a part of the structure, was not the one that you have to be. You are the one that I see the world. Yes, and you have looked after. But when you enter into a circle, when I study life, I saw life as circles. You have a church from the middle. And I have seen a church circle, you see it. When you step away, you have come in a circle of yourself. You have politician circle. You have scamming circle. You have drug circle. You have the gang circle. You have the different circle. Which one of them you step in, you are dead. If you let them in the church, they will kill you. Because you have opened the door. The serpent could not, the devil could not get into the garden until the serpent give him access. The devil can't get into your house unless you give him access. Not into your school unless you give him access. There has to be someone to give him access. You give him access, he come into the church. That's why we have problem in a church. Because men back in there will access. We have to talk about everything. Yeah. Members give devil access. Yeah. Pastors give devil access. Yeah. Bishop give devil access. Yeah. Deacon give devil access. Yeah. All of we are giving devil access to enter our lives. And when he comes, the thief comes to kill and to destroy. Yeah. You, the devil knows how valuable you are. Your soul is valuable. It is more valuable than anything in this world. I'm going to prove it to you. And that is why you are a masterpiece. God's masterpiece. You are so valuable to him that the devil can only hurt God through you. Every time you hurt, God hurt. And the devil knows that this is the only way he can hurt God. That's why he began to attack you left, right, and center. And you think that the world loves you. The devil presents everything good as if they are good. And drag you away from the world. So the world is in turmoil. The world is in chaos. Because everybody now is seeking after the things of the world. And so we find our children gone astray. So how valuable is your soul? Jesus said, what will a man give in exchange for your soul? What can you give? Anything that, look what the man of a woman. Look. He worked all his life. He labored.
Yes.
And I'm listening to you. Some he gives laughter. He never stops smiling. But look what he gets. And even this is not his. What profit has a man in all his labor? You labor, you work, you lose one soul. What can you give in exchange for it? The word, you understand to exchange something. What is equally valuable to your soul? There is no piece of land. There is no woman. There is no husband. There's no car. There's no house. There's no money. No gold. Nothing is equally valuable to you as your soul. God Almighty, Jesus said, what can you give in exchange? And if there is one here that can tell me that you have something that is as valuable as your soul, I can tell you, you can pay your way into heaven. By your way, there is nothing that is valuable as your soul. So Jesus tried to say, he tried to tell us, your soul is valuable. There is nothing here on earth that can be exchanged. Nothing you can give. Nothing you can bring. The Lord, they tried to use bull. They tried to use turtle dove. They tried to use sheep. They tried to use goat. Everything they tried to use. But this was not enough to save their soul, to deliver their soul. But one, there was one. My life to forgive. They are nailed to the cross. Nailed to the cross. Oh, how he was willing to be. With an anguish and love, Jesus went to the cross and he carried my sins to bear. I want to encourage somebody today. You are sitting here. I heard the brothers as they sing. I heard as they testify, as they talk. Heaven, listen. The Bible said there are three in heaven that bear record. And there are three in earth that bear witness. Earth bear witness. And heaven bear record to what you have said today. If you lose your way, it is nobody's fault but yours. Nobody else's fault. Jesus makes sure that he gives us the opportunity. He died for every single one of us, not just for bishop and pastors and the few members, some who people. Church people who think that they are better than you are and they are more righteous and holy than you are. But God has given all of us the opportunity to come as you are. Not to dress up and come. Not to do a big hairstyle and come. Not to go and buy a hat and come. Not to go and dress in long sleeve and come. But he said, come. Just as you are. Come just as you are. He said, I have prepared for you garment. Send out his servant and he said, call them, bid them to come. I have prepared for them that which they must dress in. I have prepared the feast. I charge you today. Is there one here? Your soul is more valuable than anything else. Anything else. Your soul. I ask you to lift your hand right where you are right now. This is his final audience. He has drawn you to God. Is your soul valuable than the things of this world? Lift up your hand as I pray. Is your soul? Is there anyone? Yes. Is there anyone else? Your soul is more valuable. Nobody's soul is valuable. Only soul is valuable. Oh God Almighty. Your soul is not valuable, church?
Yes.
No Christian soul is valuable?
Yes.
So hold on and open your hand. I ask if your soul is more valuable than anything else in this world. Lift up your hands as we pray. And I only see one lady lift her hand. One lady. My soul is more valuable. Father, As we pray for your people, you have given us the opportunity. You have given us the right to accept you. Lord, you said we must be born again. He that is born of flesh is flesh. He that is born of spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I say unto you, you must be born again. I pray that God, somebody will be born. Somebody will, God, come for a new birth, a new beginning from this. Lord, this, God, I pray that it will not wear off. It will not just go. But God, it will be a witness to Springfield. A witness to a mother. A witness to a child. A witness to a father. Cause the death of this brother to be a witness that it will reside within their heart and their mind. That there is death is appointed unto man. Once to die, but after death comes the judgment. I pray, God, trouble their mind, trouble their conscience, trouble their heart. I pray, bring a revival in this community. Bring a revival in this community. Revive your people. Revive this community. In the name of Jesus. I pray in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. We hand it over to the moderator who will finish. But I want to say to you today, keep this in mind. Every one of us will go, who next? Who will be the next? What if you're not prepared? God bless you.
Would you have to get it for us? Amen. We give the word for us. Open your heart and receive it joyfully. Praise your Lord. At this time, going on. Amen. The eulogy was written by Maya, the daughter of Patrick, and will be read by Misha, Queen's daughter. You may come now.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming to this Thanksgiving service to celebrate the life and legacy of Patrick Williams. Today we gather here to honor and bid farewell to a remarkable man who had touched our lives in countless ways. Patrick was a beloved husband, father, stepfather, and grandfather. Patrick was born to Lizzie Cooper and Clyde Williams on March 29, 1967 at Limegate, Claremont, St. Elizabeth. Patrick moved to Springdale at an early age and lived there with his great-grandmother, grand-uncle, and other relatives. At the age of 6, Patrick enrolled in Clapham Primary School in Brighton. At a tender age, Patrick was diagnosed with rheumatic heart disease. Patrick spent nearly a year in the Bustamante Hospital for Children. Following his discharge from the hospital, he required monthly injectable treatment. After receiving his diagnosis, he didn't attend school regularly due to the discomfort the injections caused. Although Patrick was later able to substitute injectable therapy to oral treatment, he ended up taking heart medication for the rest of his life. At 11, Patrick left Springdale and lived with his father in Claremont. By the age of 18, Patrick moved to Springfield. He lived with Mr. Real and the late Mas Easton. While living with Miss Beryl and Mas Easton, Patrick later met Nadine, my mom, and they fell in love, married, had 3 beautiful children and 3 stepchildren. Patrick loved and cared for his he loved and cared for his stepchildren as if they were his own. In October 2022, Patrick's doctors discovered that his heart valves were failing more rapidly than expected. Although we knew his illness was progressing, we did not anticipate losing him so quickly. Patrick was a pillar of strength, a guiding light, the epitome of integrity. He was a man of principle, unwavering in his values, and he lived his life with honor and dignity. Patrick's commitment to his family, his love for his wife and children, and the dedication to his work were testaments to the kind of person he was. One of Patrick's admirable qualities was his ability to connect with people on a deep and genuine level. Patrick made everyone feel seen and valued with his warm smile and attentive ear. He possessed an incredible gift of empathy and passion, always ready to lend a helping hand to those in need. Whether it was a or a stranger, Patrick treated everyone with the same level of respect. Patrick was a great farmer, always caring for his fields and others. He was always looking out for his animals. He loved his animals, and I'm going to just tell a little story. I grew up in a house with Patrick, where if the animal's mothers died, he would always find a little baby bottle to feed, whether it's the goat, the dog, or the cat. And just a few days before Patrick passed, I came home to check on everyone, and everyone was great. And lo and behold, we had a little kitten, and his mother died. And the first thing I said, where's his bottle? Because I know we're going to feed it. And I still have a video of me and Patrick sitting on the veranda trying to feed the little tiny kitten, because that's just the kind of person who he is. If you know him, he'll always take care of the animals. And he ensured that everything in the household was always good. Patrick's daughter Maya said she can still vividly remember their countless conversations where she shared his life experiences and imparted his knowledge. She also said he instilled in her a sense of purpose and the belief that she could do and achieve anything she sets her mind to. His words of wisdom will continue to guide her throughout her life's journey. Patrick taught us all the importance of hard work, perseverance, and respecting others. He encouraged us to pursue our passions and never settle for mediocrity. He believed in the power of education, especially because he didn't have a good one due to his sickness. He encouraged us to embrace every opportunity of growth. His intellectual curiosity was contagious, and we are forever grateful for the spark he ignited. Patrick's love for his family was unparalleled. He was not only a father, but also and a confidant of support. He celebrated our successes, comforted us in the time of distress, and stood by us even through our triumphs and tribulations. His conditional love for us was a constant. Patrick's unconditional love for us was a constant source of strength, and his presence brought us immense joy. As we bid farewell to Patrick today, let us remember his legacy. Let us honor his memory by carrying forward the values he holds dear. May we strive to be kind, compassionate, and resilient as he was. Though he may no longer be here with us physically, his spirit will forever live in our hearts. Patrick died leaving behind his wife, 3 children, 3 stepchildren, 1 grandchild, mother, father, sisters, brothers, nieces, nephews, our relatives and friends. To our Patrick, thank you for being an incredible role model, a loving parent, a source of inspiration. Your love and your guidance will forever be ingrained in our hearts. As we say our final goodbyes, we take solace in knowing that you have left this world a better place through your kindness and your generosity. Rest in peace, our dear Father. You will be deeply missed, but your spirit will continue to shine brightly through the memories we hold dear. Thank you.
That was fair.
In you as their mom. May your blessing be with them. Continue to guide and protect them and keep them safe from the arms of the enemy. I give you thanks for the family and I praise you, God, for being the God we are, to be with them even in this difficult time. In Jesus' name. I want us to, you are doing good so far. We ask the occupants of the rostrum to go. Family member, follow. Please do it in order, please. As we sing, so glad morning when this life is over. And I will. Song. Glad morning when this life is over. Thank you.
To heaven, what a day of rejoicing when we all seek Jesus and shout the victory. Get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will when we see Jesus and shout a victory.
Oh, my God.
Happy, happy home, the other side. Happy, happy to remember. Someday, no grave can hold my body down. No grave can hold my body down. Hey, come to the sunshine now.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
For those of us who are going here today, oh God, and those who are living here, I pray for your guidance and I pray for your protection. I pray for those who are going overseas early, oh God, I pray for your protection and the air. In every country, build a fence around them, dear God, as you know, broken. And in the word of our mouth and the meditation of our heart, yes, the fruit of thy side, oh Lord, was strengthened by Redeemer. Amen. Sleep and be loved. Let's sleep and take your rest. Lay down thy head upon the sacred breast. We love you well, but Jesus loves you best. Good night. Good night.
You love me like you used to do.